For a senior project, Richard is researching how much money a college graduate can expect to earn based on his or her major. He finds the following interesting facts. Basketball superstar Michael Jordan was a geology major at the University of North Carolina. There were only 3 civil engineering majors from the University of Montana. They all took the exact same job at the same company, earning the same salary. Of the 35 finance majors from Wesleyan University, 32 got high-paying consulting jobs, and the other 3 were unemployed. For geology majors from the University of North Carolina, the median income will likely be, and then we have some options here, less than, equal to, or greater than the mean. And then we have to answer the same question for civil engineering majors from Montana. The median income, these were both about median. The median income will be, and we compare it against the mean. And then for finance majors from Wesleyan, we're going to compare the median income to the mean. So to visualize this a little bit more, I've copied and pasted this exact same problem onto my scratch pad. So here it is. I can now write on this. So let's think about each of these. For geology majors from UNC, the median income will likely be, how will that compare to the mean? Well, what do they tell us about UNC? They tell us that Michael Jordan was a geology major at the University of North Carolina. So what will the distribution of salaries probably look like? So if we're thinking about the University of North Carolina, it probably looks something like this. And I'm going to do a very rough distribution right over here. And let's say that this would be a salary of 0. And let's say that this is a salary of, let me put a salary of 50K here. I'll do this in thousands. Let's say this is 100,000 right over here. And then you have Michael Jordan, who is, actually I'll do a little gap here because he's so far up. I don't know exactly what he was making, but it was definitely in the tens of millions of dollars a year. So Michael Jordan is way, 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 way up here. So if you were to make a histogram or a plot of all of the salaries, you could say, okay, well, maybe we have, if you put all of the folks from geology majors at University of North Carolina, well, there's probably, especially right when they graduated, there's probably, 1, 2, 3, I could keep doing it. A bunch of people maybe making 50K, maybe some people making a little bit more, maybe some people up here, maybe some people there, some people there, some people there, like there. Maybe someone's making 100K, maybe it's a couple of people up there. Maybe someone isn't making anything. Maybe they weren't able to find a job. And then, of course, you have Michael Jordan up here making, $10 million or $20 million or something like that. So when you have a situation like this, where you have this outlier of Michael Jordan, one way I think about it, it kind of tugs on the mean. It wouldn't affect the median, because remember, the median is the middle value. So it doesn't matter how high this number is. You could make this $1 trillion. It's not going to change what the middle value is. The middle value is still going to be the same middle value. You could move this anywhere around in this range. It's not going to change the median. But the mean will change. If this becomes really, really astronomically high, it will distort the actual mean here. It actually would distort it a good bit. So for geology majors from UNC, the median income is going to be lower than the mean because Michael Jordan is pulling the mean up. So let me fill that in. So for geology majors from UNC, the median will be less than the mean. Now let's think about the other ones. For civil engineering majors from Montana, the median income will be blank the mean. Well, they tell us there were only 3 civil engineering majors from the University of Montana. They all took the exact same job at the same company, earning the same salary. So let's say all 3 of them earned $50,000. Let's say that's their salary. So you have, if you were to calculate the mean, it would be 50 plus 50 plus 50 over 3, which of course is 50. That would be the mean. If you wanted the median, you list the salaries in order, and then you take the middle one. Well, the middle one is 50. So in this case, the median is equal to the mean. So let's fill that in. Median is equal to the mean. And then finally, let's go back to my scratch pad. Whoops, let me go back to my scratch pad here. For finance majors from Wesleyan, the median income will be blank the mean. So let's think about this distribution here. So here we have 35, out of the 35, 32 got high-paying consulting jobs. So let's say that they were making, they were making 6 figures. So the distribution might look something like this, where if this is 0 and this is, let's say this is 50K. And let's say that this right over here is $100,000 a year. So 32 got high paying consulting jobs. You might have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. So the distribution for the people who got the jobs might look something like that, but there were three people who were unemployed. So let's say they got no income. So you have 1, 2, 3. So this is now, you have three outliers, like the Michael Jordan situation, but instead of them being very high, they are very low. So they're going to pull the mean lower. They're not going to, if these were 0, or if these were 50, or if these were over here, they're not going to affect the median. The middle number is still going to be the same. But they are going to pull down the mean. So here, I would say that the median income will likely be higher, will likely be greater than the mean. Because the mean is going to get pulled down by these outliers, these three people not making anything. So let's fill that out. For finance majors from Wesleyan, the median income will likely be greater than the mean. And let's check our answer, and we got it right.